Hi everyone. Now we are going to discuss a topic called microorganisms as food. Yes, you heard correct. Microorganisms as food. We are directly consuming some microorganisms as food. For example, is mushroom and one more is SCP, that is single cell protein. In this part, we will discuss about edible mushrooms, because the mushrooms are going to be of two types. One is edible mushrooms, that means where we are consuming it. Another one are the second type of mushrooms, poisonous mushrooms, where we should not consume because they are going to possess the toxins. So as they are supposed to be consumed, obviously we have to learn about its cultivation. So in the food microbiology, we are having a concept called as mushroom cultivation. So coming to the topic here, mushroom. So what is a mushroom? So the term mushroom means in general a fungus or fungi, that is fruiting bodies. So fruiting bodies of Basidiomycetes fungi. Any fungi lacks chlorophyll. So obviously they cannot synthesize the food material from sunlight. So they have to depend on some other. So where did they get the nutrients or food? Obviously from the soil. So that means the mycelia of the fungi is going to absorb the nutrients from the soil. So that's why these are being called as saprophytes. Or we call them as saprophytes. And coming to the structure of the mushroom. So if you observe here, there is an umbrella-like structure. Or a cap-like structure, and this is how you are going to have a long stalk-like structure. This cap or umbrella-like structure is being called as pileus, and the stalk-like structure is being called as stipe, S-T-I-P-E. And if it is going to be of in a mat-like form, we call it as mycelia. And I'm not going in detail about the structure. Okay, we don't require here in the cultivation about it. And then here is a notification of the systematic position of mushroom. And the species and the genus I have given is the Agaricus bisporus, commonly called as button mushroom. So there are about 4,000 species of mushroom which microbiologists have enumerated and name it so far. So far we are going to have the naming and known mushrooms of about 4,000 species. Then why we have to learn about the mushrooms? As I already told you, we consume them. So why should we consume? What are the characters or what is the significance of it when compared to the other foods that we will come to learn? Why mushrooms be eaten? Why mushrooms have become so popular when compared to others? Because nowadays we can have the mushroom soups, mushroom curries, all the things. Why it has become such a popular food? Because it is going to have a nutritional power along with the delicious and nutritional value along with its delicacy and flavor. For those reasons, we are supposed to read about the importance of mushrooms. So importance of mushrooms should be learned because we want to cultivate them, isn't it? So let's see the why is the nutritional or what is the nutritional value of mushrooms. Mushrooms are popular for their delicacy and flavor. I already told you they are very popular for their flavor and delicacy. That means a food should be of having the nutritious value. If along with the nutritional value, if it is having the flavor also, the consumption will be more. So they are excellent sources of vitamins and minerals. So what are the different types of vitamins that are present in these mushrooms? Are going to be of your vitamin B, folic acid. We know that the folic acid is going to be the blood building vitamin useful in anemic conditions. And they also contain pantothenic acid, vitamin B12, ascorbic acid, and some precursors of vitamin A and D. So these are the certain vitamins which are present in the mushroom. Then what are the minerals that are present in it? Are phosphorus, potassium, iron, and copper. Along with the vitamins and minerals, these mushrooms also possess some essential amino acids like lysine and tryptophan. Okay, and one more important thing is these mushrooms are having very least quantity of carbohydrates and fats, hence very valuable diet for those suffering from diabetes and heart problems. Along with all these things, we are also having one more important regarding the fertilizer purpose. That means the spent compost from mushroom farms is going to be used as a good organic manure and a better substrate for biogas production. And this mushroom cultivation is an indoor activity which can help the landless, small and marginal farmers to rise their income, diversify economic activity and can create gainful employment. So because of all these aspects or importance, we are supposed to learn about the mushroom cultivation. So before going into the mushroom cultivation, we should know about the different types of mushrooms. So let's have a quick review of benefits of these mushrooms. As I said, it lowers the bad cholesterol levels, helps in preventing osteoporosis and arthritis. It helps in preventing anemia, protects hair, nails and teeth, and then it boosts the bone mineral density, protects against cancer, regulates insulin levels in body, helps lower blood pressure. So these are all the health benefits that we are attaining because of the consumption of mushrooms. Then, as I told you, these are the certain varieties of mushrooms cultivated on commercial basis throughout the world, not only in India, throughout the world. So let's see the five important types. Agaricus bisporus is a button mushroom, European button mushroom, we generally call it as. Then Volvarella volvacei, here are the spelling mistakes over there. Then Padistra mushroom, then tuber, melanosporum, black petigan truffle, then Lentinus adorans, sitake mushroom, and Pleurotus ostrotis is a oyster mushroom. So worldwide we are having these types, but in India we are having the cultivation of majorly three types of mushrooms. Those are these three, that is Agaricus bisporus, Pleurotus ostrotis, Volvarella volvacei. So here the Agaricus bisporus, commonly called as button mushrooms, remember button mushroom, and then Pleurotus ostrotis is going to be called as oyster mushroom. Then the last one, Volvarella volvacei, is going to be the Padistra mushroom. So don't get confused. The Agaricus bisporus, so here B is there, and here also you will get it as a button mushroom. So you can link this BB. Okay, then coming to the second one, Pleurotus ostrotis. So obviously the next one will be oyster mushroom. So here O is there, so here also you can have remembrance of O, oyster mushroom. So what is the remaining one? Obviously it's the Volvarella volvacei, we call it as a Padistra mushroom. Don't get confused, this P is there and here P is there. We are discussing about the species nature, so remember that only. Okay, it is button mushroom and this is the oyster mushroom, and this is Volvarella volvacei is a Padistra mushroom. So here a large, as I told you, we just going to read about the three types of mushroom cultivation, and those three types are, the first one is the Agaricus bisporus, and this is an edible mushroom and majorly grown in the grasslands of Europe and Northern America, and it has two color states, in immature white and mature another color, but majorly in the immature condition it will be white and brown color. So, and this button mushroom is also having the other names. If you look at this here, they are looking like the button, so that's why the name was button mushroom. These are also called as common mushroom, white mushroom, cultivated mushroom, table mushroom and champion jar mushroom. So these are the other names. Then coming to the second type, that is your Pleurotus ostrotis mushrooms. These are being called as oyster mushrooms, and in India it is called a dhingri. So the fruit bodies of the mushrooms are distinctly shell. So if you look here, these are all being in the shape of shell, and they can be of different colors. They can be white, creamy or yellow or pink or light brown in color depending upon the species. Okay, they are mainly found on the hard woods. Then the third type is Olvarella olvacei. It's also called as Chinese mushroom or paddy straw, as it was grown on the paddy straw, so majorly named as paddy straw mushroom. And majorly in the tropical and subtropical regions of Asia like China and India, this is going to be more cultivated when compared to the European button mushroom and your oyster mushroom. The reason is it is a fast growing one, okay, and it can tolerate to the high temperatures. So those were the main two conditions where they can be easily cultivated in the tropical and subtropical regions of Asia. And here is a picture of your Olvarella olvacei, that is a paddy straw mushroom, how it is looking like. Okay, dark gray cup like structure. So this is what in this condition it is being marketed. Once it is going to have fully opened, it won't be consumed and it will have a less value in the market. So in this part we have discussed about the introduction of mushrooms, structure of mushrooms, then the importance of mushrooms, and then what is the importance of mushroom cultivation. Then we had seen the different types of mushrooms in the world and as well as the India. In the next part, we will discuss about the mushroom cultivation process, that is how mushrooms are cultivated on commercial basis throughout the world. Mainly we will stress the cultivation methods or cultivation practices in India. Okay, thank you.